Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in English and Chinese with subtitles in Arabic, Avlaksis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese,
Croatian, Czech,
English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, and Thai. Simjanji, Zigmawa, Yanza, Simdio, Eminza, Otoch, Shugueo, Zamlingi, Togum, Su, Dagwijig, Yendamba, Riva, Gorbi, Bona, Sachembo, Devu, Toganso, Chageo, Chi, Dashoji, Satoshigin, Bobato, Ganjunsu, Bobby, Sana, Jabarjan, Дэвшин, Жанаг, Хоно, Цамсуудан, Жагардан, Баюулдүг, Бирма Жэжи, Нитасу, Чигэйо, Сайбожи, Жимба, Рикшун, Чаддо, Пагвашиг, Чайо, Нанчожи, Гойдүгдан, Гомшиг, Шүгжэ, Йоби, Сачугдэр, Түмэн, Мимби, Нанчо, Жабар, Жаншиг, Пил, Жавсу, Чайо, Ивило, Манрин, Замлынги, Чо, Гансар, Гансо, Жавган, Чимбо, Түгзэдан, Бу, Дидла, Дина, Боджи, Нанчолав, Чанжо, Жудан, Чундон, Жажу, Гойгов, Мамбу, Тов, Йо, Боджи, Жаса, Лас, Йен, Шиндир, Йоби, Бойдан, Батала, Едан, Чешин, ЮНЕСКО, Замлын, Нетлан, Chalchogji, Lovjidan, Sangrig, Rikshun Samba, Zamlingi, Chanarji, Sang, Maji, Tawayo. Boji, Zedugdan, Rikshun, Yud, Zamshik, Jitdan, Yendo, Godum, Jeju Jumvar, Gaiba, Chejung, Dering Antsoi, Chapar, Jurui Lansang, Niba, Sanjing, Nanchagr, Sansoming, Jan. Borikzor, Mirik, Shiga, Sambodang Nawa, Jubu, Ranshusu, Yobi, Gemo, Wak, Higboy, Miruksu, Dak, www.supremastertv.com/subtitles. Losumju, Lagirinla, Zamling, Togmumba, Silbi, Otsirder, Galung Nambi, Yandagbi, Gigan Chembo, Ungi, Sanja, Gombang, Nurdu, Hawikten, Jiga, Nachi Horlo, Lighterba, Dobi, Kansignamla, Ariabal, Gomgi, Tavlan, Nangiyo, Bamba, Sanjadan, Eshu Damba, Christ, Gaichi, Damba, Muhammad Kong, Kunzu, Deva, Yomvarshuk, Guru Nanaka, Lasogba, Sanja Simbi Gigenjimbo, Namboitso, Ariabal, Tavlam, Naigum, Nimlang, Jana, Yombayin, Gurangi, Gasrit, Antsoi, Jundu, Sanja Dambadam, Sanji, Jitdu, Ranatlo, Dana, Shabjuduna, Korvi, Timla, Dagdag, Dawayena, Mitovjo, Hosho, Lai, Divigiri, Zambolingi, Ganla, Migula, Dagdag Hago, Tugiri, Sirna, Kongi Sunsoi, Chinha, Ginlagi, Jamninja, Tonje, Chishoi, Due, Gurangi, Jav, Zalbatan, Jumvoi, Notse, Jandang, Achumbiba, Shogdor Rokpo Osungu Yena Baljurdan Zevi Rokpo Chindu Nayo Ri Nidong Dola Konga Shide Dama Raksum Shide Laga Namvi Tagla Damba Mambo Rakiyo Migit Mishabi Simjandu Totsekso Sunjo Ninkan Yang Kongre Kongo Mitsang Ma Somba Dayagi Niwa Shibjuk Jana Zambudin Ganda Nidan Simjang Namji Budintun Bodan Divaying Yak Si Jatse Shoy Wegen Shamali Zambudin Shik Chagare Sambi Rivala Dina Shame Otter Shalagir Chapel Nangiyo Shamajin Tadu Pil Yagi Riva Rigda Ming Mambo Yo Bi Nana Bi Shakba Yena Mitse Jurwa Tang Ige Shokhetan Zivisam Kangar Jongi Sakandan Supari Master Suktong Sarjur Ninting Maso Ansai Ma Tseshi Chagla Zambolingi Horyu Sunju Togla Yangalu Nanektan Zamboling Jurwa Tekan Jamina Tagjendang Sorgudwa Hagdan Sar Gobi Wongrik Hag Yang Yang Tugna Gichaji Shakiyo Kongi Bazinla Dina Simjang Tumbudang Devayang Yagdangmi Choja Jurwa Timna Hoyuk Sunjo Je Tugi Yorin Mirik Tun Lamdan Shide Yongili Lamkami Manda Del Shayang Ya Gi Nubatan Tusung Ginchoma Chingha Gi Lomba Rinla Zambodin Amerik Afrik Bang Yobrop Nashi Deja Tso Chimbo Rapfing Nabi Mandan Gitu Namba Tsoda Rigda Ming Orla Lugjer Chayere
Antsoy Bochi Korla Dil Shatan Oit Tortui Shigjaju Gogo Jungur Galba Sambur Oitsum Jishin Yo
Dirin Antsoy Goidak Damba Labja Kuran Su Lo Nidung Abju Dawa Guba Dari Nishu Gendin Loma Divalan Siniva Sanjinam Sinsamin Janji Chagur Inji Tsung Gairik Gawe
According to Buddhism and the believer and tradition, when you read sutra and all that, you have to put on incense, flower, you know, and bow to the sutra first and thank all the Buddhas and Bodhisattva in 10 directions, all respectfully, before you read it, okay? And then you cover the sutra also with silk or, you know, beautiful cloth, and I just make it more popular, yeah, more easy, simple. I apologize to all the Buddha. I say, if I done something wrong, according to the tradition, my heart is full of respect. It's just that I cannot always do that. So please, all the sin, whatever I've done wrong, is all on me. At least other people, they hear the names of the Buddha, according to the sutta, they will get benefit. Yes. Oh, this is a story about a person named Coppertooth, probably shining inside, you know. You know, some people, they have gold cover their teeth. It used to be fashion even. Yeah, it's just, beauty is a different taste. Like in Africa, they make the ear very big hole, put a big tree in it, a big piece of tree branch in it. The bigger, the more beautiful. And sometimes put things through the nose, the longer, the more beautiful. And nowadays they even do that. They pierce the nose, pierce the eyebrow, pierce the titties, and pierce everywhere, you know. Even put something in the tongue. And when they talk, they're showing off like, so they can see some shining object inside their tongue. Oh my God, I have difficulty chewing my food already. Fancy have to worry about that. Yeah. And in some country like Vietnam in old time, you know, they still dye their teeth black. And that's supposed to be beautiful. If a woman have a black teeth, then they call it, it's like your teeth as black as onyx, thing like that. You know, that's supposed to be a praise for a beauty in old time. My mother, when she was alive, because she belonged to older generation, you saw her teeth is still black. Yeah, because of dyeing the teeth. Nowadays we dye hair, but they dye the teeth. Understand? They also dye the hair, but black. When you get older, your hair gets gray, so they dye it black again. Okay, so different beauties appear to different countries, different tastes of people. You know that, huh? Some people tattoo all their face, you know, different way, and that's called beautiful, tough. And some tattoo all over their body, I think it's good. Oh, it's beautiful, I'd rather stay ugly. You know, needles in your body, you know. That's one story I told you already about a guy who wanted to do some tattoo, you know. And he saw some lion, you know, and he said, well, lion are the king of the animals. He want to show off that he's also like lion. So he came to tattoo shop, asked the guy to tattoo for him a lion on his back. And I lay down, everything okay. And then the guy just begin to needle him. Yeah? And the tough guy said, ow, 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 what are you doing? Which? I said, I'm tattooing you. You want a lion, no? Okay, which part of the lion are you doing? I said, and just started with the tail. So I say, forget about the tail. Do something, some other part. You know, sometimes the lion don't show the tail. It's covered in, so no need. Okay, we show the lion like sleeping with the tail under his legs. Fine, okay. And the tattooer begin again, pinching somewhere else. He says, oh! What are you doing? Where? What are you doing? I'm tattooing, sir. You know, which part of the lion are you tattooing? I'm just starting with the rear. No, forget the rear. Can you do something else first? Okay, which part you want to start? Okay, how about the shoulder maybe? Okay, so he started the shoulder and then he, ow, 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 again. And I think finally he forgot the whole lion. He come out, you know, with the tail under the legs. Oh, man. Similar like that. Mm. So I'd rather, you know, being ugly than tattoo to be beautiful. Oh, man. How beautiful can it be? Yeah? If God wants you to tattoo your body, yeah? Lion or whatever, then he would have let you be born with that, huh? Yeah. Nowadays we tattoo too much. Okay. Now, Coppertooth, the thief killer. Hmm? This story was given instructions, you know, like, though 1,000 speeches are made of meaningless lines. Yeah. Meaning sometimes we talk a lot. Just now I was talking about that. Just now we just say talking is easy, you know, and cheap. Doing it is good. So now Buddha says something like, though 1,000 speeches are made of meaningless lines. Okay, now let's see what's that. So this instruction was given by the teacher, meaning the Buddha here, eh? While he was in residence as the Veluvana, with reference to Coppertooth, a public executioner. Oh God, I hope it's something good. We are told, I mean, first I have heard, I guess, from Anand again. Yeah? I don't know why he didn't say, first we have heard. Yeah, okay, never mind. We are told that 500 thieves, less one, I mean probably 499 and half, something like that, yeah? Less one made a living by plundering villages and other acts of violence. Now a certain man with copper-colored teeth and tawny skin, his body covered with scars, came to them and said, let me also live with you. I want to join you. Yeah, okay. They took him to the ringleader of the thieves, saying, this man also wishes to live with us. The ringleader of the thieves looked at the man and thought to himself, "This man's nature is inordinately cruel. He is capable of cutting off the breast of his mother and eating it, or of drawing the blood from the throat of his father and drinking it." Blah, God. Don't let your children get hold of this, okay, until they are 21 or 18, you know, the legal age. This is not for children under 18. Yeah, just like some of the film, they say not for children under 18 or 16. This one's supposed to be for 18, huh? 16, huh? Under 16, huh? 16, yeah. 16 is better, okay? No PG, yeah? A-rate, R-rate. Mm. Yeah, too violent. Okay, this is the thinking of the thief's leader, okay? Might not be so, yeah. He was judging the man who newly want to join them. He was judging him by looking at the face. Maybe he's right, I don't know yet. We will go further. Some people can read faces, you know? Like this face is the kind of what and what character, and that face is what kind of character. Well, people change, you know? People change, yeah? In our group, we have all kind of characters. We all change into better one, yeah? Society sometimes is very unkind. It teaches us a lot of bad things. It forces us to do a lot of bad things because nobody guides us. And for survival, and for sometimes for to be like everybody else, we sometimes had to do something which is against our conscience and will. But the important is we know it's bad and we change. Okay, everybody made mistakes sometimes. All right, yeah. And after we know we change, then we don't go back again to such a behavior. Then it's good. It is still good. Yeah, it's better late than never. But it's never late to change to a better person. Huh? Yeah, and not just change, but do the opposite to recover what damage you have done. No? Okay, to your life, especially, and to others. Whatever damage you've done for anyone is first will be the damaging to yourself. It will be always like that. Hmm. That's why in every religion, always say to you, love others as much as yourself. Yes, because others are yourself. Whatever you've done to others will come back to you manifold. So never do unto others what you don't like to be done to yourself. Every religion teaches the same. Yeah? Okay. So the countries that I have mentioned, they truly do a good job. Truly love their neighbors, just as the Christianity taught. They're truly Christianity. Yeah? They're truly Christians. And truly Muslim. Muslim religion also teach people to help others. Okay? Yeah. And whatever is say that the prophet say to kill others, that is not him say that. No. They put it on after to use him to make trouble or to control. Understand? Just like nowadays, many so-called Muslim using the religion to harass people, to kidnap people, kidnap girls and forbid girls to study and all that. These are not Muslim. No. It's just something inside them, want to control people, want to get power, want to be famous, whatever. This is not Muslim. No. Just make a really bad name for Muslim. So many countries, they don't want to take in the refugees because they think they are Muslim. And Muslim for them is a bad. You know what I mean? Some people have this kind of impression. You also cannot blame them. You can only feel sorry for the really good Muslim has to be had such a collective karma with some bad people who are using Muslim as an excuse to do violence, yeah, to cause suffering and harm to other people. We only can feel sorry for the Muslim people, good one. Therefore, I'm very glad that the Christian countries taking all these Muslim refugees. Understand? This is even double good for them, double good to them. Despite that the so-called, the bad people who use Muslim and do harm to them in different countries, they still take in the Muslim refugees. And really, bravo, bravo, and bravo. We have to appreciate that. Understand? Yes. Yeah, it's good. Because if you're Christian and you only take in Christian, then what good are you? Huh? Then you still have racist, differentiate. And if you are just Muslim and just take in a Muslim, then it's okay, it's very good, but not excellent. Yeah, not truly unconditionally good. Yeah, okay. So I'm very pleased. I'm very appreciative of this Christian country. They truly are Christian country. I mean, except one or two, like Lebanon or Turkey, Jordan. Yeah, the rest are Christian countries. Yeah, and I'm very, 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 very thankful. You know, yeah, because they don't discriminate. Yeah, it's really very good of them. Double good. Yeah, double good. Yeah, if they just take in any refugees, you know, or even Buddhist refugees, peaceful, you know, peaceful people. And mostly we never heard of Buddhists doing anything wrong to anybody or any country, you see? Therefore, it's probably easier to take in the Buddhists, you know? But the Muslim has, because many people use a Muslim to do bad things, therefore, even that, the Christian country still take in the refugees, originate from Muslim religion, then I really, really deeply impressed and thankful and very pleased, and may they be blessed double for that even, you know? Okay, understand? Yeah, that's really good. That's excellent, yes. I was so pleased today to see that Slovenia opened their arms and taking 10,000 refugees. Small country. You know, very small and not very well off. Yeah, and take in, and Croatia also. Oh, these are good. Yeah. Very, these are new. You know, new on the block, joining the whole group. Oh, I'm so pleased today. I feel very good today, very happy. You can see I'm smiling the whole day through. No? Yeah, I walk in and out. Huh? You saw me today, huh? Yeah? There's a big smile on my face. I walk in and out. I was smiling, and you probably didn't know why, huh? Now you know, right? Yeah. Mostly I'm smiling, except when I have a tiger face sometimes, but mostly smiling. But today, big smile, huh? Yeah, because of that. I feel good about Slovenia and America. Yeah. Even though they're not in Europe, but they want to take in 10,000 refugees. That's a long way, you know? 10,000 don't mean a lot, but they have to pay for the air ticket for them to go from Europe to America. Understand? Yeah, and take care of them all the way. And then have to make housing for them, you know, healthcare and everything. All free at first, of course, until they can stand on their feet and find a job, until they learn English first. Do you understand? That's a lot of time, a lot of financial sacrifice for the American people. But they will be blessed. Blessed. Multiple. I'm so happy. Yes. These people, maybe they don't think of merit. They don't understand the karma concept in Buddhism. But they should know that what you sow, so will you reap. If you help others, your merit will be double, triple, you know, foursome, fiftsome, sixsome, tensome, multiply for generations. Yeah. Remember many Buddhists, that story that the Buddha told? Yeah, I mean, from himself. Yeah. Buddha don't tell lie, what for? He has nothing to hide and nothing to gain by telling lie. And Anand was a monk. He repeat the story. He wouldn't add in one word. That's why in some story, repeating some words is funny, you know? But keep it at this. I saw some of this translated, already shortened version. But I saw the real sutra. Many repeated word, repeated sentence, Anand left it all untouched. So respectful for the Buddha teaching that it didn't cut anything. And the translation in some area don't cut also. Just like sometimes I talk to you and I repeated some word, you know, unnecessary, or I corrected some word. And then you don't edit it, you just leave it like that. It is like that in many Buddhist sutra. meaning whatever the Buddha said, comma, period, slash, they left as is. Yeah. So it was really authentic and original. Hmm? Just like the song I sing, you know? Sometimes it's wrong tune, some of it, but I did not correct because it came out the way it is. I took the book and look at the poem I sing as I read. Understand? So if it's not so beautiful like professional, so be it. I didn't want to be famous as singer. Okay, I just sing it for you. Okay? In case you like to listen, then there is some music for you and my voice. Okay? Yeah. Familiar voice, you like, huh? Okay, so this leader was thinking very, very negatively of the new member who wanted to join them. Therefore, he refused his request, saying, it will not do for this man to live with us, to stay with us. Ooh. Although he had thus been refused admission to the band of thieves, he went and won the favor of a certain pupil of the ringleader by his courteous attention to him. Ah, the leader did not accept him, but he went and, you know, caught the student. You know, he's a ringleader's protege. So he, this is good. You know, sometimes it's like that. Bribery, not just with money, but with manner, you know, politeness and flattery. Yeah, so because he was very courteous, you know, courteous, I mean, very polite, very humble, behaving to this student of the ringleader, you know, of the retinue, one of the retinue people. Okay, so this pupil, student, yeah, that pupil, not pupil, no. Pupil, this pupil, very seldom I use this word. This student took the man with him, and a pupil or whatever, you know, the members of the gang, took the man with him, approached the ringleader of the thieves and said to him, Master, this man is dutiful servant of ours. Ah, you see, outward appearance and manner do sometimes fool people. Oh, bestow your favor on him, please, master. Yeah, he told to his leader, the thief leader. Having made this request, he turned the man over to the ringleader of the thieves. Ah, oh, recommended by your favorite member. Of course, ne? Okay, so one day, the citizens join forces with the king's men, capture those thieves. Oh, took them to court and arranged them before the lords of justice, you know, Supreme Court, I guess, like nowadays. Né? The justices ordered their heads to be chopped off with an axe. Oh, man, they're only thieves. They didn't kill people, no? Or maybe they did. Sometimes the thieves kill people because they don't want to be recognized or don't want to be reported. Yeah. The justice ordered that has to be chopped off with an axe. So, said the citizen, they asked, who will put these men to death? After a thorough search, they were unable to find one single man who was willing to put them to death. Nobody wanted to chop their head off. Nobody wanted to. Finally, they said to the ringleader of the thieves, you put these men to death and we will spare your life and give you a rich reward besides. Oof. You kill them, huh? Tell to the leader of the thieves, say, you kill your members. But because they had lived with him, he also was unwilling to put them to death. Oh, at least he has some moral. Very good. In like manner, also all of the 500, less one, I mean 499, okay, let's say 500 less one, so I say 499, okay, refuse, oh, probably include the ringleader, then it's 500, okay, 400, 500, less one, yeah, okay, refuse when asked. Last of all, they ask that scare Tony Coppertooth. Yes, indeed, he said, consenting. He said he will kill them. So he put to death all the thieves and in return received his life and rich gifts besides. Phew, that's terrible. But he was very scared, you know. He already had no way to go to live his life, so he joined the thieves. And now if he didn't do it, he's done for. Eh? Even the thieves didn't want him. The ringleader was right. When he saw him, he said, this man is very cruel, very violent. He would do anything, you know, kill in a violent manner. Therefore, he didn't want, even the thieves did not want to accept this man. Incredible, huh? Even the thieves can see faces and predict their personality. Either they're peaceful or violent. Understand that? And even thieves, they have their moral. You see that? They did not want to kill their own member just to survive and have richness. So thieves are not always as bad as we think. Of course, thieves are bad. Now we don't say, we don't encourage this kind of behavior. But in some people, in high society, or in some high political position, do worse thing than thieves. Thieves, they only take your money. But some cruel people, some either in high position or some cruel people, they even take your life. Money you can re-earn, right? Or you can borrow to survive meanwhile. Life you cannot borrow. You cannot rehab, you know, re-earn another life. Not immediately like that. Wow, so easy. So sometimes people punish the thief so cruelly. Like in some country, they chop your hand off. If you're caught, if you are at the thief. Or if somebody say you are a thief, who knows, somebody sometimes wrongly accused, you know. They say, chop your hand off. Yeah? Chop the hand off, how are they going to become a good citizen again, if they want to? You understand? They cannot work anymore. Yeah? So, it's a very cruel practice, and it does good to no one. The thief, they already stolen the things. People already lost money. One person or one family already give grief because of loss. Yeah? The best is to give that family of loss if they need some money to return for that. And make the thief go work for labor or something to redeem their bad deeds. And maybe they have a chance to turn around. See? Some thieves do turn around. Some criminals do change. You see? Some reason. The religious reason or something touched them, or they just fed up, or they originally did not want to be thieves or to be criminal. They have been forced to do it. So the whole society or government are to be blamed also, not just that person. And the education system, the parents, the background, the friends they have, the influence. Come here! He's crying outside. Come in. Cakes, where are the cakes? Give me some cake for him. Come up, yeah. Cake, give me cake quickly. Come here. Are you a good boy? Good boy. You're a wonderful boy. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you are good boy. Say hello. Say hello. Paul. Sit down and Paul. Sit down, sit, Paul. Yeah, you beautiful. Everybody loves you. Paul. Shake hand. Yeah, shake hand. You are good boy here. Shake hand again. Who you like? Who do you like now? Sit and shake hand. Anybody you like. Oh, just symbolic, huh? Nah? If you don't want, sit down then. Come on, here. You are a good boy. Yeah, good boy. Yeah, here, give. Just like this. No, like that. Otherwise, he might bite your finger by mistake. Are you a good boy? Okay. No one will shake hands. Don't do that. After he finished. I'm so glad that he people friendly now, because before he's not like that. I had to bribe him whenever some new people come, sit far away and throw some bone first, you know, veggie bone, vegan bone, then slowly, slowly go near. And he's still skeptic, you know, he run away. He go and steal quickly the bone and he run very far. Somebody help to clean later, okay? Sorry, I don't have a bowl here. Is somebody please bring him water? Where are we? Where were we? What did I say? Okay, okay.
Chop pad out.
Chop pad. You like that part. Okay, sorry. Okay. All right, so now, in like manner, also they brought in the 500 thieves from the country to the south of the city and arranged them before the justices. When the justice ordered their heads to be chopped off, they asked each thief, beginning with the ringleader, to put his companions to death, but found not a single one willing to act as executioner. Another different group of thieves, yeah? They also brought there to be judged by the court. And then they also asked them to, the ringleader, to chop the other's member head off so that he can live and richly, but he also refused. And even the member also, none of them are willing to chop each other's head off to survive, to live. Wow, imagine, huh? The thieves, they have the bond of brotherhood. They have their own moral standard even. Imagine that, yeah? Many people would be willing to sacrifice their own even family member just to live, and live richly even with reward. No, they don't. You see? So you see, the thieves, sometimes they are forced to be thieves. Because they were, like, maybe family hungry, have no job to do, or, you know, the society forced them to be thieves. But they just steal, you see? They steal, mostly they steal from rich people, understand? They don't do nothing more, yeah. So then nobody want to chop the other member off, including the ringleader. So then they said then, it's enough for now, okay, boy? All right, there's a vegan bones for the teeth. I don't have time to brush him now. He been brushed already after dinner. Now he eats again, so I give him some of this.
Gracious viewers, thank you for watching Buddhist Stories. And my name is Coppertooth, part 2 of 3, on Between Master and Disciples. Coming up next is from the Holy Bodies, Tipitaka Samyutta Nikaya, the Grouped Discourses, Devata Samyutta Divas, on Words of Wisdom. Please stay tune to Supreme Master Television. May Providence guide us in wisdom and love. For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/BMD.